Like many things in life, practice makes perfect, and rhythm games are no exception. However, I'm not gonna lie to you, getting good at rhythm games can get very expensive. You're either looking to buy a machine for the low, low price of $16,000, or you'll be committing quite a bit of money just to master one game. Also, it may not be the most convenient thing ever to just go to the arcade to practice on a regular basis. Couple that with a fairly steep learning curve, it's kind of no surprise that rhythm games are still often seen as a novelty or something that only weebs play. Then I thought to myself, well frick, I have nothing to do. So, might as well ring in the new year with a video about how both newcomers and veterans can get good at rhythm games without having to spend a ton of money. But first, I want to preface that this video is definitely not a definitive video on how to get good. There are a ton of other good videos on the subject, and this is only me putting in my two cents. So if there are any techniques and tricks that I missed, well feel free to comment down below or even make your own video, cause gosh dang it, we need more people talking about rhythm games. But with that out of the way, let's get to it. Now first, despite how crazy difficult rhythm games can be from an outsider looking in, it actually isn't about hitting random notes flying at high speeds, it's actually kind of methodical. That's because, at the end of the day, when broken down to its most basic level, getting good at rhythm games is mostly just pattern recognition and muscle memory. Using DDR as a reference, we have this basic pattern called staircases, where you basically move your feet in a pattern from left down up then right. And now, keep this in mind, because this pattern will appear in different songs and in different difficulties. The only difference is the tempo and the speed of the arrows. However, the overall pattern and execution is the same. Though of course, there are other patterns, such as crossovers in DDR or M-runs in Pump It Up. There are even variations to the staircase pattern that I mentioned earlier. And as much as I could talk about these other patterns from these different rhythm games, that would take a whole specific video. So to keep it simple, I just want to emphasize that getting comfortable is really just about getting used to the patterns and practicing them enough to the point where you could just do it on command. Now that we've covered the basics, let's move on to some of the techniques that you could use to build that recognition and muscle memory. The first method that I want to go over is called shadowing, and it's the most monkey brain method ever, but I find it to be one of the most helpful methods out there when it comes to getting comfortable with rhythm games, especially when you're first starting out. It's convenient as you don't really have to go anywhere, and it helps you get a feel for the game and your skill level without having to spend money on the arcade. In addition, it helps build that muscle memory for some of those more unique patterns. To do this method, you first want to visualize the control scheme of the game you want to master. So let's say you want to get good at DDR, you would want to visualize the arrow panels in the directions of up, down, left, and right. Then you act as if you're playing the game. At this point, you don't really have to do anything, as now you are just trying to get used to positioning, but once you feel comfortable, you can move on into looking up charts. You can find charts from all sorts of rhythm games on YouTube, but feel free to pick a song that you'd like, as now you're just trying to get comfortable with playing the game. Once you select a song to practice, just follow along with the chart as if you're playing the game. If the notes are too fast, feel free to slow down the video if you need to, and feel free to look up other charts if you find yourself stuck. Once you find some charts that you do like, you should probably save them in a playlist for safekeeping so that you have them all in one place. This method can be applied to almost every rhythm game, but there are some games where it's harder to shadow, like Taiko no Tatsujin. So while I do like this method, there are some things to keep in mind. The most obvious drawback is that you don't really have the tactile feedback that you can get from the machines. As a result, you also can't really get feedback on your timing. In addition, you just might look a little weird, but I'm pretty sure you'll be alone in your room, so it's not like anyone's gonna be watching, right? All in all, shadowing is a great way for people to really simulate playing on an arcade machine. You can practice and get a feel for your skill level without having to whale tons of money trying to find it, and it's a method that you could do in the comfort of your own home. If you're interested in this method, I'll be sure to link some channels where you can find some charts down in the description below. With that said, let's move on to another method that you can use. Because if you're someone who likes the tactile feel and real-time feedback that you can get from the machines, that's where the simulators come in. Because while shadowing helps you get physically acquainted with the patterns, simulators are more for helping you get mentally prepared for the chart. Not only will you be playing charts that are faithful to the arcade counterpart, you're also given a lot more flexibility as to how you can play the game. As unlike shadowing, you can adjust settings such as note speed and offsets, as well as other things to fit your preferences. However, while simulators are great for practice, there are some things to keep in mind. Some of the newer games, like Wacca and Dancerush, do not have their own simulators at the moment. In addition, these simulators also operate in a legal gray area, so you might have to do a bit of digging around. And you also won't be able to get a one-to-one arcade experience, as you can't really use the arcade control scheme, at least not without throwing in a bit of money. But don't worry, pretty much all of these simulators will allow you to use your keyboard to play. In any case, these simulators are free, and they don't really require a top-of-the-line computer to play. So if you're looking to try out a simulator but don't really know where to look, I'll go over some of the most popular simulators. For dance games such as DDR and Pump It Up, there's Step Mania and Step F2 respectively, and while I can't directly tell you how to get the charts, there are certain sites where you might be able to find them. Moving on to games where you use your hands, Taiko no Tatsujin has reliable methods that you can use to practice. There is a Taiko simulator called Taiko Web that you can play straight from your browser, but if you want something that is more, let's say, legal, there is a home version called Taiko no Tatsujin Drum and Fun on the Switch. On to some other games, Sound Vortex has K-Shoot Mania and the unnamed SDVX clone, Beat Mania 2DX has Lunatic Rave 2, and if you're big into Guitar Hero, Clone Hero might be perfect for you. Of course, these are only just a few of the rhythm game simulators out there, as listing all of them would just be adding fluff at this point. To finish off, I recommend simulators if you mainly want to work on sight reading charts as well as get instant feedback on your performance. Thus, you can get an accurate indication as to whether or not your ability to sight read can translate into hitting notes. And as a bonus, these simulators can be treated as their own game with their own custom charts and with some having literal competitions and streamers for them. In the end, I believe anyone can get good at rhythm games, yet actually getting good is a commitment of time and money. And when you have to spend that money just to get a feel for your skill level without any confidence about whether or not you'll be any good or get any better, I can kind of see why many people choose to pass over the rhythm games in favor of those rigged ticket games. So my hope is that this video has made rhythm games a bit less intimidating as well as provide helpful methods for people to practice. I'll definitely link some of the YouTube channels and simulators that I use to practice in the description for you to check out. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope that many of you will use these methods to get comfortable with rhythm games. Other than that, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.